Hey Virgos, thank you so much for watching this video and let's see what cards are showing up for you this week and how we can improve your week. So yeah, let's see for Virgo. The World Tarot card in the first place shows up together with the Page of Cups in reverse, the Queen of Wands, the Star Tarot card, Nine of Wands, Queen of Swords, Magician, Knight of Swords in reverse, Three of Pentacles in reverse, and a Three of Cups. Okay, so you're taking control of something. You're completing something, you're ending something. Because this was maybe a little like childish behavior. Maybe it's even confusing people a lot. Well, this is maybe serious business. There's something serious going on. Because the Queen of Wands here is taking the lead. She's taking control of the situation. Maybe you are making things a little more positive at the moment than they actually are for the people all around you, because you don't want to make them worried about anything. So, and this is what you're going to manifest. You're taking the lead. You're making sure everyone is all right and taking all that action that is needed to make sure they are all right. So I think you are taking a lot of responsibilities on you at the moment. Because maybe of some thoughts that you're having or some opinions that are going around maybe about a person, or there's something going on. And before I started this reading, I already felt like some tense. So maybe this is for you guys. It felt a little bit like a little bit like a nervous kind of energy. It's a bit tingling, or how do you say that? Like a little bit like nervous energy that you know something is about to happen, but you don't know exactly what. I don't see here the Moon card showing up, but maybe this is for someone around you. Like they know something is about to happen, but they are not aware of it, what it actually is. And so you are making sure that you're bringing the message across in a nice, friendly way, or maybe not a nice friendly way. I mean, the Queen of Wands is not someone who is she's also maybe not, she's coming off of as very cheerful and energetically, but she's not necessarily not like the Queen of Cups, for example, that she is very emotionally involved in something. She's more making sure that everyone is staying alert and that they're ready for taking any action. So that's what I can see what's going to happen this week. And of course I will continue my reading, but that's what I see in the current place, in the current position. So at this moment when you're watching this video, or this week, what this tarot reading is all about, you will see that you probably need to take on a role to bring something across in a very cheerful, positive way. Because actually maybe something else is going on under the surface, and it's maybe not right for these people to know it right away. Because the Queen of Wands is like any king and queen, she has a leadership role. So that means that if she's going to spread rumor, or if she's going to spread fearful messages, then she knows that everyone, like a good leader, knows that they don't have to spread messages that they don't have any solutions for yet. And a good leader also knows that they have to bring that message across in a way that people know what to do. And so the Queen of Wands is definitely not someone who is spreading this kind of rumor. And this is very important this week to tell it in a way that is that people know what to do, and that people know what your vision is on upon this subject. The Knight of Swords in reverse, like I already did, like it could be like communication that you can't get out of your words. It might be very difficult to tell something. It might be very difficult, very hard to bring something across towards someone. It's very hard doing it. It's maybe you're struggling over your words. You are not knowing how to do it. Maybe this is how they see you right now. Like Virgo want to tell something, but they can't, because they don't know how to tell this certain thing. So they already know that something is going on, if you wonder like what they think. But they know there's something going on, but that you don't know how to tell this certain thing. And the Queen of Wands is about traveling. It's about making sure that these people know about it. In the middle of the week, the Queen of Swords is showing up, so you're probably going to inform someone about this. I almost feel, and this is really part of the reading because I know the difference. This is something that brings you maybe like headaches. This is something that really gives you a headache. It's something that's on your mind all the time, and that's probably why you want to end this. And that's why the World Tarot card is showing up. It's something that's really on your heart. It's really, you really want to speak up about this certain thing. It could also be that someone in your environment feels like this. They really, really want to tell you something badly. They want to express these feelings. These feelings are very important to them. And they want to express them to you. And so they don't know how to tell this. So someone definitely wants to tell you something, but they don't know how to bring it across. And they will probably tell it in a way that is super nice, is what it gets. Super nice. Super nice. I never say super nice. Okay, this is like a super nice message. It's like a message. Yeah, sometimes these messages I get, it's thank you guides. But I, super nice message. So it's like a message that is... It's almost like you're going to do something fun, but that really reminds me of World War II or something. I'm sorry, maybe you don't get it, but maybe some of you do get it. It could be that someone is about to tell you something in a super nice way. Yeah. So, in the past, the Nine of Wands is showing up together with the Strength Tarot card in reverse and the Death Tarot card. So, you're very careful about something in the past. You was very careful about this. You was careful, but you still, I mean, with the Strength Tarot card, people can see you're very cautious and you're really aware of like, oh, what's the next move this person is going to do? What is the next move this person is going to make? And so this made changes on the other party's side because the Death Tarot card is showing up for them. So, and the Strength Tarot card is clarified by the Eight of Wands in reverse and the Six of Wands in reverse. It's almost like you are letting yourself be so much influenced by not really on your focus, and that's probably what you need to be doing this week, and that's what you're also going to do. More so being focused on these things that you do want, and because you can realize it no matter what. I mean, Queen of Wands and a Magician. So you are realizing this certain thing if you want to, because you are not in your strength about a certain success, about not telling someone about your success or about their success, but there is something that is being hidden, and it's about success. It's about some kind of success that they don't know about. And maybe you feel even carried away. I get carried away. It's almost like you're influencing, like you're being influenced by maybe other people's behavior. You are very careful with a person that's in your life. This doesn't have to be necessarily a lover. This could also be someone else in your environment. This could be a friend or just someone who is contacting you, someone who wants to be really in contact with you, but you don't know exactly why. This doesn't have to be sexual. This doesn't have to be anything. This is more someone that is being focused on you right now. And it sounds a little bit, maybe a bit scary, But this person, you are their goal maybe at the moment, or you have someone on your target that's your goal. And you knew in the past that you have to be careful with this person, or be careful with something that you did, or something careful that what this person did. So you're not completely in your strength about it, because you wasn't careful with this, and so maybe some success was slipping through your fingers. This person, the Death Tarot card is showing up for them, together with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse and the King of Wands. And it seems to be a very serious reading. I really feel that vibe, and I have it in every of my videos. I'm completely in it, you know? So, yeah, it's almost theater. So, the Death Tarot card is showing up together with the Knight of Pentacles in reverse, and that means that they're working and working and working, and nothing, it just doesn't work. Something doesn't work for them. They are working very hard. They're searching for a certain kind of control over this, but it seems that they can't. And with you, that success slipped through your fingers. So I think maybe you are a team, or maybe you're doing something together, and maybe you need to have that same goal in mind. Because right now it's almost like you both want the same, actually, but you're working separately on that same project in a completely different way. It's almost like you are bothering each other while you want both the same, and you could be both happy together, being very happy with the results. But because you are doing it, because you're not working very well together, both, while you're both working your asses off. I think that if you're going to work together, or if you are, if this person wants this, because I think there's also something going on with some separation. It's almost like this is a little bit separated. They don't know maybe you're working on the same project, or they don't know something about this, that you are. It's almost like, you know, get the pigeon kind of situation. Like, why is that guy in this cartoon always trying to chase the pigeon? What's actually the goal of this all? It's really useless, it's impractical, and I think you're both missing right now that success, because you are putting a lot of effort, maybe your whole life, maybe half of your life, maybe a part of your life you already spent on this certain thing, and nothing is coming off because you are working against each other all the time. There's a lot of fire on both sides, so you are very fiery, maybe there as well. Maybe you have a lot of fire signs in your chart, then this message is for you. If they have a lot of fire in the chart, this message is for them. And this person, it's like you're both working your asses off, but you're working really against each other while you want exactly the same for the same project. So I think here there is, it's incredibly like a waste of time. And this is also something that you are both knowing, like you're aware of this. So it's almost like, what I see right now is a little bit like, I don't know, with cartoons, because it's a little bit like a cartoon. This is a little bit like a cartoon situation, that one person is here and other person is there. One has a hammer in their hand and they're knocking the other person on their head. And then that other person is knocking that other person on their head. It really doesn't make any sense. So maybe this week things are about to change. And it's a little bit stupid as well. It's just, I'm sorry, it's very stupid. It just looks very stupid, and it probably is. So there might be, this might not resonate for all of you, but there might be something going on right now in your lives that you feel maybe a little bit stupid about when you're going to think about it. Like, why did I actually do it this way? And that's also why this message is coming up. It's not to talk you down or anything. It's to help you on how to improve your week. So when you know about this, that you did it in a way that doesn't work, because it's like you're exactly your boat skills, you're both doing the right things, you're both knowing how to do something, you're both very successful people, but you're knocking each other down. So this is a lose-lose situation. So instead of working against each other, you might want to work with each other or make a win-win situation out of this, because there is plenty of of possibilities here with the two of you. So yeah, I get a message of a woman who's doing something with hair, or maybe you're in a hair business or something, and yeah, maybe you're also watching these series, like, you know, these women that are having like bitch fights or are treating each other like that. I think this is influencing you big time, and this is not what a woman I'm sorry to say this, but I don't know, I'm not going to tell it. This is just an opinion maybe, but I think you really need like a better, and this is maybe already something you made a conclusion about, like, I'm watching the wrong television series, I'm watching the wrong people, I had like wrong inspiration in my past. There are also other women out there that really want that success, and they get that success, and you are so fucking skilled and you are so successful in whatever you're doing, and now you are maybe battling against someone that's actually maybe your partner in business. So it's really time to do things differently. It's what I see here. It's really time to do things differently, and this person, you will make each other successful. I think here there's some kind of bitch fight going on. Could also be two men, of course, but visually it works better when I say woman, which is actually a pretty sad thing to say, but yeah, it is, because we do have those television series about these kind of women and people like it, so yeah, it's pretty popular, and we think it's normal, and we think that this is what women are like, maybe even in a worst case. And I think you're now getting over this idea of women, you're getting over this idea of what you should be, or what these inspirational figures are doing, that this is the greatest thing you can do as a woman. And right now I'm very focused on women, but it also for men, maybe this is your feminine side, that you think that this feminine side is very much about bitch fights, that it's very much about I think there's very really like an unrealistic idea of women for some people who are watching right now. And so yeah, it's very good to do something about that, because these people that you know, when you're seeing really their real skills, they are very important, they can be very important to you, and you can work together with them, and you can make each other grow, instead of, I don't know, why is this subject coming up? Let's see. Yeah, I think it's only confirming it, the Queen of Wands together with the Nine of Cups and the Five of Cups. I think you're also very sad about this. Maybe this makes you angry. This makes you very upset. Maybe you're being seen as a woman like that. Because maybe maybe you are having one of these channels. You're like, you're having YouTube readings, or you're doing something else on television, or something in public, and maybe you are wearing a certain kind of makeup, or you're doing something in hair business, or because I just got hair business for some reason, and you're doing or something with makeup or beauty, something like that. You really love doing this, but there's such a stigma attached to this, and this is a very specific message, so maybe this is not for all of you, but keep watching, because I will get to other subjects as well. But you are, maybe people see you, they see you really a little bit like that those kind of women that are bitch fighting, or something with porn or something like that. Because they do have a lot of opinions about you, and this is a lot of hateful opinions, especially on women, especially on your looks. And maybe that's why you stopped even wearing makeup while you are in beauty, or you are doing something with it. Maybe you're even earning money with this. maybe this is your living, this is your job, but because people do not understand this, you can't even be yourself anymore, because people are so childish towards you, and they are seeing you, they're not seeing you for who you are. And that's really a pity. And if you're dealing with these kind of people, I think this is a real problem. I don't think only for you, because otherwise this wouldn't be a video right now. This is a very specific message. I think really this is something very important. Yeah, it's something very important. It's about people's looks, it's about jealousy, it's about not seeing, only looking at what someone looks like instead of really trying to find out who someone is on a more spiritual level. And there's more layers to people than only what you see on the outside. And then your life is getting pretty interesting. So I would say, if you're dealing with these people, they don't have really a life. They don't know that there's more they can get out of life. And that's really sad, because that's their whole life, what it's all about. So they don't even touch those other subjects. There's much more in life, and they don't see it, they don't get it. So it's actually really a pity that these people are doing that. So don't be bothered about these people, because it's just but why are you resonating with these people? Why are you resonating with these people? I mean, are you in the wrong kind of groups of people, or are you inspired by the wrong people, for example? I see here the World Tarot card, so that means that you are about to end this cycle. You are going to find your tribe, people that are on the same page, so that are focused more maybe on being successful in the things that you're doing, being passionate about these things. Maybe you're going to really find those people that are inspired by you. This might also have to do with the way you are saying things, or how you communicate. So in the middle of the week, you will also you will find out how to, maybe by watching other videos, like how to bring something across in a way that people get the message in a different way. There's of course a lot of ways of how to say things, but of course a very huge part of it is how people perceive you and how you look, because this is the first impression people get from you. So yes, it is realistic to present yourself in a way that people know what the subject is about, for example. Yeah, it doesn't mean that if you're talking about tomatoes, you have to wear a tomato suit or something. That's not what I mean, but just kidding. So this is about, you know, presenting yourself in a way that, for example, if you're having a YouTube channel, or if you do something in business and beauty, then of course it's of course great to look nice. But if you're not doing something with beauty, maybe it's a little bit like a waste of time if you are very beautiful when you are doing a video, because maybe it's more so focused on your cards. So this is more like a certain creativity that you are going to get out there about your branding, about the way you come across towards people. So yes, it is a big part of the business, like the way you look in a certain way, but it doesn't mean that all people want to see someone very beautiful, because that could be sometimes distracting as well. So it really depends on what the subject is about, and because of this subject you want to because of this subject you just want to bring something across in another way. So with a tarot reading you can have your hair like this, that's alright, it doesn't matter. But it is attracting people's attention, so maybe it is they're going to think that it's about hair that is all everywhere, you know. So But I stop about hair because there are also some other people watching right now that don't have anything to do with hair. Maybe they're having a business as well, because the Queen of Wands is about business. But I think here that it's important to have really like a vision on your business or the success that happened in the past. I don't think this is very much about your love life in the first place, but we get to that later. So I think here that most importantly, this is something that really has to do with the combination of what are you bringing across, more so the message, like what kind of message are you bringing across, and how can your looks apply to it. It's not first your looks, it's first the message you bring across. So it's first about that message that you bring across, and after that the way you look. And if people are going to bother you with their opinions, then maybe this is just not interesting for you, or maybe you can learn something from it, maybe you cannot learn something from it. But if this is bothering you a lot, then this is probably something to work on. And I think also you're going to manifest this. You're going to manifest exactly the right kind of message that you want to bring across towards people. So this is what you're about to do. This is what you're working on this week, really about your branding, about bringing across your personality, like who you really are, not being afraid to show who you really are, and not to be too reserved, because the Queen of Wands isn't reserved. She's reserved in a way, but not, she's not afraid to express her, so to say, beauty. And her beauty is not always the way she looks, but also her great personality traits. So the Star tarot card shows up together with the Six of Pentacles in reverse and the Hanged Man. So that means that you feel hopeful again about something. And I think there's a lot of jealousy here towards you, Virgo. A lot of jealousy, or this jealousy is coming from you. But I think for most Virgos, you're dealing with jealousy. Whether it's you or this other person, but you're dealing with jealousy this week, and you're going to end something. You're ending this cycle of emotional underdeveloped people in your life, or people that emotionally not very much developed yet. So maybe you are growing older, maybe you are a young adult and you are becoming a little older, a little bit mature, a little bit more serious about things, and this is just not interesting you anymore, and you want to do something that is really resonates with you, something that really resonates with you, and you want to be on top of the game. Yes, and if you want to know that if you're going to stop with a certain business, yes, the other people, you are maybe only focusing right now on the people that are jealous, the negative people, and these other people that really love your show, that really love your work, that really love something that you're doing right now, are really sad that you're leaving. They're really sad. So there's not only people that are hateful towards you, there are haters always, but it's always very a small percentage of the people, and they shouldn't have that much influence over you. Then these other people that maybe don't say anything, but these people are really loving you, they really appreciate you for your work, and they really love it, what you're doing. So these people are sad about it, that you are not there anymore, that you are not going to do this anymore. So yeah, it's really a pity that it has to end like this, but I think you are going to make that decision from a rational point of view. Maybe it also doesn't bring a lot of money in, because I don't see a lot of money here. Maybe it only costs a lot of money here with the Six of Pentacles in reverse. And these other people are waiting for you all the time, like where is she or he going, because we really love their show, we really love this person's energy. Where is Virgo? They really miss you, and I think that you don't want to do this anymore, or you are going to do this in a different way. So you can you can do this in a different way if you want to. You probably need to take some time off though. I think also that maybe whatever happened to you this is going to heal the audience or this target group, or your customers, your clients, this person is going to heal, this group of people is going to heal from this certain thing. They are going to think differently. When you're gone, they're starting to miss you. So yeah, they will miss you. So the Queen of Swords, let's clarify the Queen of Swords in the middle of the week. I get the Fool and the Page of Pentacles. Yes, you're starting all over again, like I just said. And this is, you're coming up with something different. You're coming up with, another way of bringing the message across, focusing more on the message than on the looks. And because people are sometimes a little silly, you know, about women and their looks. So maybe this is something that you were victim of. And I think that, yes, you can wear whatever you want. For me, that's fine. But a lot of people are not so open-minded about this. And so this is probably what you have been experiencing. And so you're going to do things differently, but you can stay true to yourself. It's not that you have to be so completely someone else or that you have to wear a mask. But maybe this channel or this subject, I have a strong feeling that there's some YouTubers watching here right now as well. But I have really like a very strong feeling that this is something that is keeping you busy, that you probably have been thinking of a lot. You have really like information on how this works, and you probably did a lot of research about it. So maybe you're even starting a channel about this subject, or on your channel you're going to start specifically to tell messages about this certain subject. And I think you will touch people, or how you say touch, you will really they will really feel you, because you're not the only one who's dealing with this problem. And you're not the only one who's dealing with this problem. There is a complete group of people that is dealing with exact the same kind of problem that you experienced. So yeah, and I think you will find your friends through this. You will attract these people that you really want to attract to you. And for people watching right now, like maybe you're asking yourself, why is she talking all the time about hair business? Well, this is just what I, the message that I got, like hair business or beauty or something like that. So for other people who doesn't resonate with hair or beauty, I would say this is something like a job that you're doing that is very public kind of job, that people see what you're doing. And it might be beauty related, but it could also be something else that is very much out there and people can see you. So yeah, in the end, like I said, the Three of Cups, the Justice card, and the Four of Wands. I think here the Four of Wands in the first place they might not come to your channel or I don't know what kind of jobs, maybe your business, maybe your artworks, maybe they're not in the first place because they can't relate to it just yet, or maybe because of what you did previously. But you will get, in the end of the week, you already see some, or in the end of this process you're busy with, you will see your friends coming in, like real friends. So for Virgo, real friends are coming in. Don't worry about it. These bitch fights will be over. This is just the wrong target group. Could be. It could be the wrong target group, or this is people you have been attracting that missed your message, that interpreted your message in the wrong way. And maybe, yeah, of course you can't help it. If you're beautiful, yeah, people have already some jealousy or some ideas all around you, about you, that because they're jealous, because they see what you look like, and that makes people jealous. So because they want it as well. But of course this could also be your topic, like how to become like me or something like that, like maybe like a funny topic, like yeah, it could be like humor or something like that. So I think here, don't take it too serious in an extent that you you can't find the fun in it yourself as well. That almost feels like a personal tarot reading, but I really hope that that you feel that this helps you for this week. And for other people who feel that doesn't resonate, you're always welcome for a personal tarot reading. Just click on the link below. So in regard to your love life, I would say you are very careful about someone or something. Maybe you already have been in the past just touching a little bit upon that subject that you want to talk about. Or you already have been trying to approach this person. Maybe you already felt very highly sexual feelings for this person with the Strength Tarot card in reverse. And so this was maybe not the right thing to do. Or this person liked it, but they see you as like maybe Casanova, or this person maybe sees you right now a little like a Casanova, or like they don't have control over their feelings, or don't have any control over their, maybe they think you're a little bit impulsive in a way, or maybe that's something you fear that you think like, oh, this person is thinking, what do they think about me right now? Because maybe I was a little bit too passionate showing this, while maybe you wanted to be a little bit more patient. So something happened pretty fast with this person. You and this person were pretty fast with something, and that also changed this other person's mind. Maybe they felt even we was too fast for them, being too impatient, or this is what you fear, because there's a lot of fear on your side that this was not the right way, that you did it, that it wasn't the right way. Yeah, so how you're going to present yourself during this week towards this person is you're going to you decide for yourself that you're going to do something about maybe that shyness that you feel. Maybe that's also that you find it hard to take that action while you really like this person and something's really blocking you. And so you are really done with this kind of shyness that you experience. And so you are, you are going to take a different approach towards this person. You're going to be a little bit more fiery, a little bit more maybe sensual in a way, or being a little bit more fiery in any case, a little bit more cheerful, a bit more playful, I guess. Maybe to show this person in another way that you really like them. And you're afraid maybe, or there are a lot of opinions about this person, about you. And the Queen of Cups in reverse is that you can't get in touch with maybe your feelings. Maybe you find it just very hard to express your feelings towards this person. It's like they're not collaborating with you. It's like you're sending out these messages like, hey, you know, and you're not getting any response in return. Like, hey, I like you, you know, but you don't get any response in return. This might be because this person only wants to be friends, or this is that you think like, okay, this is just not for me. This is really like a friend and nothing more than a friend. I just can't. So, and it could also be that this person tried this on you, that they really tried to, they were really impulsive, like they were right away, just very fiery towards you, while you don't want it. You're not really charmed maybe of the way they are doing these things. And so maybe you or this other person is going to change the way you behave towards each other, and you seem to be more friends than lovers, I think, with this person. Because the Three of Cups is showing in the end of the reading, and I see the World Tarot card, so there's an ending of some kind. And in the middle of the week, you are also going to yeah, you were having more like a logical approach, a more rational approach towards this person. You are going to behave differently towards this person because you see that it's not working the way it does right now. So it's more, it feels more like a friend to you probably than more than a friend. Yeah, so in this cheerful way, in this way you are approaching this person, you will manifest this friendship that you want with them. And if it's not even a friend just yet, you are going to manifest that this is becoming your friend. And maybe you just start off as friends. If you really want to be in a relationship with someone, you probably start off as friends first, because the magician is showing that you are leading this person in a certain direction, and they are, what do I see actually on their side? I don't see much feelings at the moment, but as might be because the Hangman is also showing up, that they're waiting upon your response, or they're waiting like, what does Virgo think about me? Because maybe you find it hard to make that first move. You might make it hard, find it hard to make that first move. And so they're waiting just for your response. And they're actually pretty sad at the moment. Like, why is Virgo, does Virgo like me? Or does Virgo like me not? Something like that. So they didn't make a conclusion yet. Maybe you don't know each other that well yet. That's also a possibility. But what I see for this reading is that you are both, it's really like a search. You are more in search of yourself and try to find out what's the best way of doing things. And they are in search of what do you like. Do you like them or not? Do you like them back? They want to know if you like them back. So thank you so much, Virgo, for watching. I really appreciate it. Also check your Sun, Moon, Rising and Venus signs. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the like button, and see you till the next video.